Hello and welcome back. In this video, we are going to look at how to use text masks. Now in the previous video, one of the previous videos, we already looked at how to use shape masks. And in this video, we'll look at how to use text masks. So where can you use text masks? You can use them in so many different designs. You can use them on posters, especially on posters, magazine covers if you want to, or you can even use them on book covers or social media posts, and also just catchy designs for various advertisements. All right, enough said, let's get into using text masks. So here I have set up a slide, and on this slide I have the big text sample, and this is using the default font, which is Poppins. I don't know if you changed it on your platform, but for me it's still Poppins. So this is the default font, and I have sample written out here with a background, a gradient background selected. All right, now we are going to apply a text mask to this text. If you don't know, let me just add another text and show you how we do that. So you add the background first, go to text, click on add heading, subheading, or whichever you like. I like to add heading. So once you add the heading, let's get this one up here, double click on it to select the entire text and change it to any text you want. Okay, and then if you want to make it larger, smaller, you can use the corner handles to drag to the size you want. Okay, now let's get rid of this text. Let's work with this. Select this text. So I'm selecting the sample text. Let's just keep it there, sample, and we have the contextual menu opened up again. Where is the text masking option? Which one could it be? Which one could it be? It's right here. Add text mask. Now, in case you get confused with the options here, don't worry. Just hover over any of these icons and you'll see what exactly they are. So you don't need to get confused. So when you hover over this, you'll see add text mask option. So what we're going to do right now is click on that and add our text mask. Click. Okay, like we saw in the shapes video, the color has disappeared and we have the text ready to be masked. Let's go into photos now. Click on any of these. You can add any of these. I'm going to go to Pixabay and let's search for creative now masks. Okay, different masks. Let's see if we can add any of this. This one looks good. Let's add that in and check how it looks. Click on it. All you have to do is click on the photo that you want to add to the text mask and it should be done. Let's watch. Okay, it looks... Does it look anything like the picture? No, I'm not able to make out anything of the picture. But can we do something about it? While this is selected, look at the cursor. I'm going to click and drag up or down. Drag up or down to adjust the image in the text mask. Okay, so we... Alright, now can you see a little bit of the eyes there? Maybe. So this looks a little better, but still it doesn't have that effect that normally text masks have. I'll tell you why. Let's go to the next slide and I'll tell you why. Take a look at this font now. It's different from the default Poppins. I've changed the font to Archival Black. Now there are some more fonts like this in Plasfy, and if you don't like any of those fonts, you can upload your own. This is a big bold font. So whenever you're looking at masking, look for big bold fonts. Okay, something that's thick, or if you might want to call it fat, okay, not thin. Let's apply the same image and see what it looks like. Let's go to add text mask here. Let's click on the same image and let's see if it makes any difference. Give it a moment. Should be done. Okay, is it any different? Where are the eyes? The eyes are there. Is it any different? I feel it's a little different. Of course it is different. Is it better? I still can't actually make out the actual image of the mask in this text mask. Okay, so that's going to depend on how I've arranged the font here or the text. I'll show you some more examples so you'll know exactly what I mean by that. But what we're doing here is moving the image. Now what I want you to understand is that I'm not able to move it sideways because the image that we added is a landscape image. Now with that selected, let's change the image to this portrait image and I'll show you something else. Okay, we added the portrait image and now see I can't move it to the left and right, but I can move it up and down. I can move it up and down. All right, so that's something you gotta remember. And if you have a small font and if you enlarge the image that you added as a mask, then you can move it either way, vertical or horizontal. Let's go to the next slide. Moving on, I've got a picture of a beautiful landscape, a seascape actually, and I've got the text here, explore. Look at how nicely it sits on the horizon. Let's make it even better. Alright, so here's the image that I've got. Would you be able to identify what actually is in the mask? Would you be able to identify based on this little text here or maybe the shape of whatever is in there? Are you able to identify? Now whenever you choose masks for your text, make sure you choose images that actually will be identified by the viewer. If they're not identified, then there's no meaning to masking your text. Now this here is a plane. This looks like a vacation spot, so you're gonna fly to this place and then you're gonna have other text advertising what this is all about. So make sure you do that. Let's go to another one. So look at this one, Rocky Alps. Now how did this happen? It looks okay. Let's see another one. This is better. Okay, how does it look? So are you getting it? It looks like it's blending in. So here's a trick for you. Now if you want to create the same effect with your text mask, all you have to do is make sure that your text is large, which is here. The background image and the mask image are the same. You need to make sure that the background image and the mask image are the same. And once you do that, you click on your mask. Okay, here are some more options. Once the mask is added, there are some more options for you to work with. What I added here is just a shadow. So shadow is here. Click on shadow and you can adjust the settings to whatever you like. And if you happen to change the color, just make sure you click on apply for the software to apply the changed color. First time the whatever is selected here will get applied. Alright, and as you already know, you can use any of these functions here. For example, let's move to the previous one. Let's click on this. Okay, this is a mask. And if I click on this, remove clipping mask. The clipping mask is gone. Okay, let's undo that. And if I click on image filters, you know what it can do. Different filters. Look at this filter. Looks like it's embossed into the mountain itself. Okay, so you can work with different creative filters here. Let's move on to the next slide. Okay, we already saw this and how you could use some filters and effects to make the text mask blend in with the actual image. The next one. Here's another example of what you can do. I've got this background of leaves and the text here, gardenia. And I've got some floral image masked in it. I've added the shadow green. You can see it. It's gently there. It's subtly there. Just remember, in graphic designing, less is more, always. Let's see if we have another slide. Okay, so this one is slightly different. Okay, what you can see here is that every letter of this word, this entire phrase, Disney Paris, has a different image. So how did I create this? It's very simple. I created a different text box for each alphabet. So for example, let's go to this, add a heading, and let's get the heading out here, or maybe let's do it on a different slide. Okay, just to show you what I do. So add a heading, we're gonna give it P there. Let's make it bigger. Okay, we have a big letter here. Let's change it to this. Now I'm gonna duplicate it, put it there. I'm gonna PT, Plasfy Tutorial. Okay, so now I select each of this, mask it with an image that I want. Okay, that's an image. And I can go into the next letter and do the same again. Okay, go to the next letter, text mask, and select maybe this one. And we'll have two images there. Take a look at this image. I can move it to adjust it. Okay, this one, I can move it to adjust it. And we have our individual letter masking. So let's go back to the previous slide, and that's exactly what I did here. Okay, I've got Disney, Paris, and for Paris, I've got all photos of Paris into this, and I've got another background of Disney Paris here at the back. So this is with the horizontal or the landscape images that you would want to create. I'm going to show you in a bit what you can do with vertical images. Okay, so hold on. This is a vertical image, and mostly you have vertical images which are quote images. I never dreamed about success. I worked for it, Estee Lauder. Okay, so I've made some changes here. I've got the text here, and then I used the line height and grouping to adjust the line height and the spacing so that they're all closer. So whenever you have text, a lot of text, if they're closer, the image that you mask into it will look better. So here's what I did with it. This was the first one I worked with, and it looked okay. It didn't look the way I wanted it to, but here's what I did with the new line and space adjusted text. Do you see that this is a lot better than the previous example? Because the text is all close, the line height has been reduced, and you can actually see the image inside. It's a wonderful way to work with text in a vertical format. Let's look at another example. So here we have the background of a tiger, and here I've got tiger burning bright. If you notice, I've got some shadow going on here, and I've also got the image of a tiger within this text. Overall, this image looks good. Okay, let me see if I have another slide. If not, I think this is the last one. That's the last one, but I hope you got a good idea of how to use text masking in Plasfy for your graphic design. So you can use things like this for your magazine covers. If you're building magazines, if you're creating lead magnets for your business, you can do that. If you're into publishing books, you can publish some books with creative titles like this. For your blog banners, you can do this. For your ads, Facebook ads or Google ads or any ads that you're working on, you can do this. For your LinkedIn posts, you can do this. And the use cases are limitless. It's just as limited by your own imagination. Okay, so take your time, go through all of these options. Make sure you test them all out. I'm sure you're gonna have a lot of fun. Okay, so here's bye from me, but I'll see you in another video.